Hey, my name is Salman Chisti, or Salman MKC. I'm an intern at Microsoft and I have 16 certifications. And the question lots of people ask is whether or not certifications matter. And, how do you get them for free? How do you do all of these certifications? I'll give you some tips as well. But yeah, let's get straight into the video because, certifications, they realistically can change your career. It's a possibility. You don't want to block that out, but do know that you don't just focus on certifications, it's actually what comes out of certifications, and that will be, one point I'll talk about, okay? So firstly, what I would like to say is that with certifications, what you kind of avoid with certifications when you start to learn something new is this whole idea of getting stuck into beginner, medium, and advanced level tutorials. This whole idea of starting a new technology. I'm not sure how many of you have experienced this, but when you look for a tutorial, you see beginner, and you do that tutorial, you do the medium level tutorial, and it's the same thing as the beginner tutorial with a bit more, okay? So you start to do that, and then you think, okay, I've done this, you skip ahead, and then they start introducing new things, so you have to go back, and then you start re-watching the whole thing. You might as well have just watched the whole thing from the beginning. So really, with certifications, each of these courses, they have a set, specification. They're all gonna be similar, and then the next certification, the next course for that certification is gonna have different content. It might just build on the previous content, so you don't have to worry about any, discrepancies and anything like that. So which path do you choose? It's kind of a weird question because I get asked this a lot, and I can't really tell you, hey, go into do dancing. It's not like that. I can't tell you go do cloud. I can't tell you to learn AI. It's up to what you really want to do, because whatever you're passionate about, you will go the furthest in my opinion, because realistically you're going to be doing this as a day job, hopefully, so 365 days of the year. So me telling you to go ahead and do data, but you're not interested in data at all, and then you just end up hating what you do, that's not gonna cut it. So really, just try everything. And then whichever one you feel, the most interested in, go down, find a certification path, and go set that as a higher goal. And yeah. So how does this goal thing tie into things? So another cool thing that certifications add is this, this higher goal, right? This sense of direction. So when you start doing a course, you may not know what it's gonna cover. Again, this whole beginner tutorial, it might not say you're gonna learn this, this, and this. With the certification, this whole skills outline, you know what you must cover in order to pass. So you really have to have that expectation before you go into it. And then you're not just aimlessly learning random topics. Like I was doing this C sharp project, and this is also a problem with just doing projects. You start to only use the knowledge you know. So there's often five different ways of solving one problem. And if I only search a query on Bing or Google, saying, okay, I have this problem, I only know certain words to describe my problem, limited with my knowledge, like I want to decrease the memory usage with strings. If I don't know about string builder, for example, in C sharp, I might not come across that in my answers. So it's really about having that extra source of knowledge, which then later you can go back to your project and be like, oh, okay, I could have used that. So it's sort of like the whole idea, when you play an instrument, you might not necessarily learn the best way of doing things at the beginning, but you'll figure them out as you go along. It's that tacit learning sort of approach. It's similar to competitive programming as well. So if you could brute force a solution, you may not know that there's a much simpler way of solving it. Perhaps you use sliding window or something else, but because you don't know that concept, you might not come across it. You might not try. You might just keep Googling things or using Bing until come to a solution. Another big thing people ask is, do certifications help in career prospects? I definitely think that they can, but it's not a guarantee. Okay, if you don't get a job after getting a certification, don't worry. The whole purpose where I think certifications really, show a good thing about you is that you have that growth mindset. You're willing to learn and keep developing. I always mention this in my 5 resume tips video, in my first internship video, everything like that. Check it out as well. You want to show that you're willing to learn and also live that, because on the job, you don't stop there. You keep doing this, and one way to do that is through certifications. Because sometimes when you go into jobs and you don't know how you can improve, sometimes doing certifications gives you that goal to hit. But again, that's not the only aspect. Again, hands-on experience, mixing it all together is a great way. Combining them, I think it's the best combination. So do certifications help with career prospects? I was actually speaking to university recruiters from Microsoft the other day, and one of them actually said that beyond university, they want to see you're doing other things as well. For example, hackathons and certifications, other things like that, even running a podcast. Things that you do beyond university really stand out, and that is, certifications are one of those. They're literally a thing you can put on LinkedIn. So, I mean, if you can, why not? There's this whole culture of sharing your achievements on LinkedIn. So, if you can share a certificate rather than sharing a dog picture or something, then that's brilliant, okay? Yes, you do want to show your personality as well, but literally, I post it a lot and it sort of inspires other people to do it. I see people building websites, building applications, it inspires me. So, you want to be the average of the five closest people around you. So, if you create that network where you inspire people, they inspire you. That's a brilliant thing to do, and I think companies love that. Now, okay, some tips I have for certifications. You sort of get used to taking them, so you know the approach over time for me. So I like going through the skill outline, I like finding a course online which will go into the concepts. There's videos, tutorials, there's Microsoft Learn, sort of mixing different learning styles together really gets into my mind, because I like to do a hands-on approach where I'm actually able to do the thing, because I need to be able to do this as a job as well. I need to be able to actually validate I can do this sort of thing. So hands-on approach is actually called tacit learning. So when you do tacit learning, you see things from your perspective. Yes, you could read one perspective in documentation or from a video, and they might say, okay, it does this, but they might skip the small things in between because they have that prior knowledge already. So really trying things after you've learned about it is the best approach for me. Also active recall or spaced repetition, if it's like definitions of words, there's really not much to it. But just trying it. Literally, just try things that you learn. Do one concept, try it, then go back. Test yourself on it, do one set, do another. Just keep looping that. In terms of how do you get free certifications, I'm gonna link you this website over here. You can see an Azure Fundamental course. You go find that. Once you do that course, you pretty much get a free voucher normally. You should check beforehand if you do. Also, I did this post a long time ago. There was like an Oracle certification you could have done. A lot of these companies will do promotions where you just look out for free exams, okay? You look out for discounts. And oftentimes, for example, if there's a beta exam, there might be a discount or something. So you basically, you have to be on the hunt for these things, but you save a lot of money. Now, whether you want to spend thousands of pounds or not, that's really, I don't think you need to do that. You can go to events as well. There are certain events. If you're in London, if you're in London, BET is a good one for that. They hold free certifications there. And you have all these promotions going on all the time. Follow me on LinkedIn. I do post things if I find them and share that. I literally shared like 20 or so links, and it got like 1,600 clicks within all the links. I had a track on all of the links, so yeah, a lot of people used it. So do check these things out. There are limited ones, so yeah, follow me, subscribe. I will try to update all of you. Yeah, that's really it for this video. I would like to finish and say I love learning. It's that whole growth mindset. You just keep doing them, you get this delayed gratification, and you're like, oh wow, that was really worth it. And then you do another one, and you get addicted to this whole process of, constant learning. It's not all about certificates. This is just one aspect. This can really help you a lot. Okay, it might help you 5%, 10%, but work on the other areas as well, open source, things like that. I can do videos on that. Let me know if you do want that. And yeah, hopefully you enjoyed this. This is my first video as an intern, so I hope you all have enjoyed. I've been doing a lot of work, so, you know, having to balance this. I'll try to do another video next week, and I'll try to do this weekly. So I'll see you next time. It's been Simon MQC. Do tell me what you want to hear next. Subscribe and leave a like. Bye.